Hello friends, in this video I will be talking about rules on subject verb agreement that I have already revised with my students of class 10.
Hey everyone, today we are going to revise a grammar topic, that is subject verb concord. Let me revise you with the rules. First is rule 1. Rule 1 is the verb and subject must agree in number, singular or plural. This means that if the subject is singular, the verb should be singular, and if the subject is plural, the verb should be plural. So here are the example. He plays. Now he is singular, so the verb which agrees will be also singular. It is plays football. Now the second, let us take the example of plural. They play football. So the basic rule is this: a singular subject needs a singular verb and a plural subject needs a plural verb. Now rule 2, the number of the subject, singular or plural, will not change due to words, phrases in between the subject and the verb, right? Like example, one of the glass. Now one of the glasses. Now but see, the particular stress is given to the one only. So here the verb which agree will be singular. So the answer will be one of the glasses is empty. Here since the subject is one, the verb should be is. The bouquet of red roses smells so sweet. Again here, since the bouquet is a collective noun, so the subject and not roses, the verb should be smells, not smell. Now rule 3, subjects that are joined by and in a sentence use a plural verb. Subjects that are joined by either or, neither nor, use a singular verb. Let me give you an example. Radha and Meera are coming home. Neither Akshay nor Rohit is coming home. My dad or my mom is arriving today. Now where there are choices, again the verb which agree is singular only. Now let's discuss rule 4. The verb in a sentence containing or, either or, neither nor, agrees with noun or pronoun closest to it. Suppose I give an example, neither the shoes nor the bag matches the dress. Now shoes are plural, but the bag which it comes in the later. So here the pronoun matches will come, which will be the singular. Here bag is closest to verb, hence matches will come, so it will be singular. But whereas if I write the sentence in a vice versa, neither the bag nor the shoes match the dress. Here what is near to the verb, which pronoun is near to the verb or noun is near to the verb? Shoes. Now shoes are plural, so here shoes is closest to the verb, hence match will come, which is a plural. Rule 5, when the subject is followed by words such as well as, along with, besides, not, extra, ignore them and use a singular verb if subject is singular. Let me give you an example for this also. Matt as well as dog is expected shortly. So you are here ignoring as well as his dog, because here you will not consider plural, here you will consider it as a singular. Prateek along with his brother is going to school. Again you hear the main subject is Prateek, you are ignoring his brother. So it will agrees with a singular verb. Now rule 6, in sentences that begin with here, there, the true subjects usually follows the verb. Fine. Suppose here are the chocolates. Now are is plural, so chocolates are plural, are will be there, so the verb used will be are. There is a big puddle on the road. Now puddle is one here, so we have used is. Now rule 7, in sentences that include sums of money, periods of time or distances extra as a unit, we use singular verbs. Like 500 rupees. Now 500 rupees is one singular currency note, one rupee note only. Not so for that we will use singular. So 500 rupees is a high price to pay. 62 years, no doubt 62 is a plural, it sounds plural, but years means it is a it's indicate the year for a particular child only or for a particular person only. Okay, so 62 years is the minimum age of retirement. 10 kilometers, no doubt it is sounding like plural, but still 10 kilometers is too far to walk. Now let's come to the rule 8. In the case of verbs such as a lot of, all, some, extra in a sentence, pay attention to the noun after of. If noun after of is singular, then use a singular verb. If plural, use a plural verb, right? Suppose, let me give you an example. All of the cake is gone. Now after of cake word is used. Here cake is singular, so we have used word is. But whereas if I write a sentence, all of the cakes, then cakes here sounds plural, so are gone, right? A lot of cake is gone. Again you have to just see what type of subject is being used, whether it is singular or plural, then the verb will agrees according to it only. Rule 9, in the case of collective nouns, you know what are collective nouns, like a group of sheep, a class of students, a school of fish, populations, family, these are all collective nouns. So the verb can be singular or plural depending on their use in sentence. Suppose most of my family, now family is a collective noun and again it is sounding as a singular, is here or are here, half of the population was against the build or were against the build, it is all according to the sentences. Nouns such as mathematics, civics, physics, news will plural in the form, but are singular in meaning and use singular verb only. Like mathematics is very difficult for some people. The news is very interesting or the news is very saddening. Now the last but not the least, the rule 11, the most important. In sentence that express the wish, request or contrary to fact, the word were is used instead of was. When you wish, suppose I will give you one example. I wish my sister were here. So it won't be was because you are wishing and still then it is a conditional. When you use a conditional sentence, you will not use was, whether it is a singular pronoun or noun, you will use were only. If I were a millionaire, okay. Aditya requests that she raise her glass. So these are all rules which I have simplified and made a note of it. Go through it, listen to the video which I am sending thoroughly, carefully, and then solve the exercise which is already given here at the end. Try to solve it, do it in your notebook, and then later on cross-check with the solution which is given. Be honest at your part. Thank you and have a nice day.